It's been 8 months in the making, and now the second season of Formula E will be decided in London's Battersea Park as a dramatic doubleheader race weekend unfolds. Heavy showers rain on the parade of the title rivals during Saturday's qualifying session, leaving Sebastien Buemi and Lucas de Grassi to start the race in the middle of the pack.
We go green in London, and it's a lot of wheel spin for Bruno Senna. Looks as though Prost has got a good start. Senna tucks into second position, a lot of darting in the middle of the pack.
Despite the narrow track, both championship contenders deliver another masterclass in overtaking. Buemi climbs from 12th to 5th, while de Grassi converts 10th position to 4th.
And de Grassi is going to look in his mirrors and see that blue and yellow Renault car right up behind him. It's victory for Nico Prost and victory for Renault in Battersea.
It's a stroll in the park for Nico Prost, who seizes the day with a comfortable win from pole. He started in front and stayed ahead throughout, while Bruno Senna is second with his first ever podium in Formula E.
There's the champagne, there's the delight, and there's the victory for Nico Prost.
At the end of Saturday's racing, de Grassi is still only marginally ahead and leads the championship by 3 points. Tomorrow's battle with Buemi will go down to the wire, but for now, it's time for all the teams to recharge their batteries. Formula E is a really entrepreneurial sport. It's always pushing boundaries, looking at innovations. And one man who is very well known for that is Sir Richard Branson. And he's actually just joined us now to support his team. And about perfect timing. So Richard, how are you? Lovely to see you.
Extremely well.
I think you said last year that you were hoping, or you expected, that by 2020, Formula E would overtake Formula One. I mean, do you still believe that? Are we on track for that?
2021, maybe.
Give or take.
No, but I think I think it is going in the right direction. It's pushing the boundaries forward into what will be the future. 15 years from now, I suspect every car on the road will be electric. So in the same way that Formula One helped improve the quality of the old-fashioned, you know, carbon-guzzling cars, Formula E will push the technology of clean energy.
And now it's time for the drivers to take to the track again. Whatever happens, by the end of this second day of racing, Nelson Piquet Jr.'s reign as champion will be over and we'll have a new name on the trophy. Qualifying has rarely been kind to Sebastien Buemi this year, but today he ends the jinx and secures pole position for the first time this season. It earns him 3 championship points to draw level with de Grassi at the start of the race.
To be honest, it's a miracle that we are in this position right now to be fighting against a much faster car like the E-Dams proved to be all over the year. We did a fantastic championship, myself, the team. We extract every single point that was available to us, 0 mistakes, apart from Mexico, which was a big one. But we're going to race fair. We're going to be aggressive, fight hard like we did yesterday. And going to push for it. We're going to fight until the very last lap.
But the best laid plans of mice, men and motorists can go awry, and did so from the very first lap.
They have exactly the same amount of points, 153. There's 2 points for fastest lap, but excluding that, whoever finishes in front on the road will win the championship.
This start is critical, absolutely critical.
We go green in London. It's a very good start from de Grassi. Is he going to be able to pull alongside and try and attack Nico Prost on the run down to turn one? He's not quite able to do so. Tucks in behind Nico Prost. How aggressive is he going to be coming down into turn three? Into the left-hander, he goes side by side. Oh, he hits him!
He's hit him!
I don't believe it! The two championship contenders out of turn one. Can you believe it's happened immediately?
The collision leaves both drivers too far behind to score points for finishing places, but nevertheless, the race continues while the championship rivals limp back to the pits.
Okay, Lucas, we're going to do a car change and we're going to try to go for fastest lap.
All Buemi needs to do now is come into the pits, change over into his other car, set the fastest lap, and he could win the championship.
With 2 points available to the driver who records the fastest lap, the season title will be settled in a high-speed shootout in their second cars. While the two championship contenders position themselves for a winner-takes-all super-fast lap, the race continues with podium places and the constructors' title still up for grabs.
He keeps it all together and goes
Bird
round the outside
him.
Of Turvey.
The Battle of Britain there.
And
passes him.
Oh, there's an attack, and that's big, big work from Duval, and slams into the side of Simone de Silvestro. So Prost, it is leading. This is on board with Antonio Felix da Costa, who's now in eighth position. Look at that. How close can he get to the back of Nelson Piquet Jr.?
Apparently, Formula E is becoming a contact sport.
At the moment, Nico Prost leads, 8 seconds clear of Daniel Abt in second place.
With a mere 3 laps to go, Buemi makes a final attempt at the fastest lap.
And they've timed it so Buemi comes out behind Prost.
Yeah, coming up behind Prost. Yeah, you just get out there and go as hard as you can.
Across the line comes Sebastien Buemi. Is it going to be even faster, 24.58? Did it beat? Yes, 24.150. Great lap. And that's it.
While the championship victory is in the hands of Sebastien Buemi, his teammate Nico Prost is about to claim the race.
The checkered flag falls. Prost wins.
C'est qui le patron ici?
Renault, yes! The champions.
The combined efforts of the Renault drivers also secures the constructors' title. It's the perfect response for Buemi after the disappointment of losing the title by 1 point last season. But for Degrassi, a disqualification for an underweight car during the Mexico E-Prix earlier in the season has proved costly.
It's very clear from the data I just saw. Seb braked very early, about 50 meters too early. When I was fighting with Prost, when he realized he braked too early, it was too late for me to hold control of the car, and that was what caused the impact. We've been through the data, and that's very clear.
And in terms of the championship being decided on the fastest lap, what do you think of that?
It's not really fair to have points for fastest lap. We are here racing, but that's the rules. And we tried our best. We gave it a go. We did everything possible this year and the impossible. And to be honest, to be losing by only 2 points from a car which was clearly much faster the whole year, I'm proud of my championship.
Sebastien Buemi, this really came down to being the fastest man on track. Huge congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. It's difficult to realize. I was not expecting to celebrate it that way, but now we'll take a few minutes. The team won it and we won, so I'm more than happy, yeah.
More than happy. Emotions must be running very high.
Yeah, because it was a tough season, you know, and to start the race and, you know, with what he did, I didn't know what to think, you know. I just thought he wanted to try anything. And then even for the fastest lap, he was waiting for me to not let me do the fastest lap because he knew we were quicker, so he was waiting all the time, and I used a lot of energy for nothing. So in the end, I think the best driver and the best team won.
And he sprays the huge bottle of winner's champagne on the podium, and Nico Prost gets involved as well.
It's Renault Edams and Sebastien Buemi who have been crowned the driver's champion of the Season 2 FIA Formula E Championship. And it's Renault Edams who have been crowned the team. So there's going to be loads of celebrations. In fact, you can see it's already starting, an extremely large bottle of champagne. We cannot wait to come back to do it all over again for Season 3 with more drivers, more teams, more technology and even more cities. The new Formula E champion has recorded a special message for Supercharged viewers. Go to our website to see that and recapture the story of the season. But for now, let's enjoy Renault's moment in the sun as the London weather finally smiles on the French team at the end of a hard-fought championship. Shine like gold.